Whatever happened to that steam engineer? Time's gone on by now and he's disappeared. I used to see him wave at the train roll by. Steam engine's gone now and I don't know why. I guess the train's rolled on now, he's a part of the past. Things just keep on changing, but the memory lasts. Things keep on changing, but the memory lasts. Things keep on changing, but the memory lasts.
In the spring of 1981, the wild California poppy still blooms alongside the Golden Gate Bridge. The bridges to San Francisco now carry only auto traffic. A quarter of a century earlier, there was also rail traffic from one side of the bay to the other along the Bay Bridge. Now, the remnants of this traffic is to be found only in rail museums, such as this one, just south of Los Angeles, the Orange Empire Rail Museum. We saw much of the rolling stock of this museum in Train Watcher 1, and today we see in operation a car which was not operating during our first visit. This is the double articulated streetcar that used to traverse the Bay Bridge from San Francisco to Oakland. Operated by the key lines, it too, like many other rail lines, succumbed to the onslaught of the private automobile, and today the Bay Bridge traffic is exclusively motor vehicles. Thanks to the dedication of volunteer museum members, rare rolling stock such as this have been restored to operation. When in Southern California, be sure to visit the museum in Paris. And remember, there's much more of the Orange Empire Trolley Barn in our program, Train Watcher 1. Not far away, alongside the Pacific coast at Del Mar, California, we see one of the most traveled Amtrak routes, the San Diegan, from San Diego to Los Angeles. 7 trains a day make the trip between the two Southern California cities along the tracks of the Santa Fe. From this point northward for 30 miles, the train rolls along the Pacific to San Juan Capistrano, where it then cuts inland. the Oceanside Station, we climb aboard the San Diegan for a trip north to Los Angeles, where we see the picturesque Los Angeles Union Station. Nearby in Griffith Park, we find the Los Angeles Live Steamers warming up their tracks for a weekend run. Adjacent to nearby Travel Town, the members run their inch-and-a-half scale trains on weekends and are open to the public, offering rides behind the members' engines of various types. Simulated with gas motors, but the steam engines are actual operating steam engines using real coal in their fireboxes, heating up the water in their boilers, and generating real steam to power the engines and their whistles. Sacramento, California, we see the Amtrak San Francisco Zephyr as it departs the Southern Pacific Station and crosses the Sacramento River Bridge, one of the largest movable bridges of its type in the world. Directly adjacent to the bridge and the station is the State Railroad Museum, also the world's largest. We are here at the end of April, days before the official opening. The final preparations are being made after years of building and restoration. Most of the museum's equipment is inside, but we were able to get a glimpse of some of the rolling stock outside. In this recreation of a Central Pacific station, totally restored engines from the early days of steam are backed in with their elegant cars as if ready to carry passengers off on an imaginary voyage into yesteryear. All around the grounds, rolling stock from various periods receives last-minute attention from the museum crews. Specially sent for the occasion, we see the Rocket, England's first steam locomotive, as it arrives for temporary display during the museum's opening festivities. A complete roundhouse and a working turntable has been included in the museum's features. Stock can be moved about and displays changed, as in this instance, where we find engine number 112 being moved outside for display at the opening ceremonies. Just inside the door, we catch a peek of some of the displays, including this overhead narrow gauge track, which carries an operational train on a level above the ground floor displays. After the museum's opening, we returned again with our camera to catch a view of some of the displays inside the main building of the museum. Named trains of the past were immortalized in this display, bringing back memories of passenger railroading at its height. This restored private car gives a glimpse of the luxury that once rode the rails, probably never to be seen again by the generations of today, except here as a museum piece. Other displays inside the museum are mainly beautifully restored engines from the early days of steam, painted in their elegant colors with shiny brass and chrome embellishments. They surely must have been an inspiring sight as they rolled into the towns of the past with their colorful cars and visitors from faraway places.
Across the entire country from sea to sea. Here comes that railroad. I want to be an engineer on the railroad. Steel rails coming right through town. People coming from miles around, chugging its way to
Interesting walkthrough display is the restored Canadian National Pullman sleeper car, Saint Hyacinth. Real ride into the past, we climb aboard this 1961 Rocky Mountain excursion train. Rolling across the southwest desert, this special 18-car all-Pullman train was made up of units from both the Santa Fe and the Union Pacific, over whose respective tracks we were to ride. The highlight of the trip was to be a ride behind the newly retired Union Pacific steam engine number 844. In her second year of service as an occasional excursion engine, she was to pull us today single-handedly over the legendary Sherman Hill in Wyoming. President of Deluce Video, supervising our first rail film in 1961.
Things keep on changing, but the memory lasts. Things keep on changing, but the memory lasts.
From the past to the present, as we retrace our steps some 20 years earlier, this time with a new generation of rail fans. We're in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and this is the new superliner version of Amtrak's Southwest Limited. When we were here last on the Rocky Mountain excursion train, the Santa Fe was still running its passenger service, the Chief and the El Capitan. It was on that run that the Santa Fe high-level cars were introduced in the 50s. In Train Watcher 2, we saw the Southwest Limited racing through the desert with its all high-level cars. Now, here today on this new Superliner version, we can still spot some ex-Santa Fe high-level cars as we note that the Superliners are just a bit taller than their earlier predecessors.
Thank you.
At Albuquerque, we part with the Southwest Limited as we head north to Denver to once again see Union Pacific's 8444 on an all-day excursion for the Rocky Mountain Railroad Club. We catch sight of 8444 as she is ready to depart the station at LaSalle, just outside of Denver. At the station in Sterling, Colorado, 8444 reaches her destination. Here, after servicing and watering, the train will be wide and then return to Denver by nightfall.
Thank you.
On this July day on the plains of Colorado alongside the Platte River, the temperature is exactly 100 degrees. Working in the hot cabs of locomotives on days like this is a test for man as well as machine. Just a few months earlier, we were train watching on the Northern California border outside of Klamath Falls at the Mount Hebron summit along the Southern Pacific main line. Waiting for Southern Pacific steam engine number 4449 on her way from Portland to the opening of the California State Rail Museum in Sacramento. Unfortunately, she was late in leaving Klamath Falls, and after 3 hours of springtime snowfall, we were to wait a bit longer until we caught her just south of Dunsmuir. Thank you. were to see much more of 4449 on her visit to Sacramento and Los Angeles, be sure to catch the full story of this beautiful engine in our program, Return of the Daylight, an entire program devoted to this magnificent machine. Deluce Videos, Return of the Daylight. A bit further east, we see the Amtrak San Francisco Zephyr, eastbound along the Southern Pacific tracks. Racing ahead of her, the light fading, we catch the same train as it heads out into the desert outside of Sparks. The next day, along the very same tracks on their westbound journey from Cheyenne, Wyoming to the RailFair 81 in Sacramento, we find the pride of the Union Pacific, engines number 3985 and 8444, coming into the SP yard at Sparks, Nevada.
Okay.
With a day's layover here in the Sparks Yard for servicing, the double-headed ferry run to Sacramento will be completed the following day as the two UP engines retrace the original route of the overland trains across the Donner Summit and the Sierra Nevadas to Sacramento. There, after attending the RailFair 81 museum opening festivities, they will return to Cheyenne along this same route.
Thank you. Engine rolling on the tracks, puffing that smoke right out of a stack. blowing that whistle and she's always on time, rolling those wheels on down the line. They say she's the iron horse with a thousand legs to run. Steam engine, keep on rolling along, your life has just begun. The rails keeps turning me on. The whistle cries its plaintive song. The clickety-clack of the silver track is a rhythm from the past. Through the valleys and the trees, through the towns that used to be. Locomotive 8444 will be on time, just you wait and see. It'll be on time, just you wait and see. Steam engine rolling on the tracks, puffing that smoke right out of the stack, blowing that whistle and she's always on time, rolling those wheels on down the line. Thank you.
by Frank Bolter, music by Leroy Schull, copyright 1981 by Deluce Video. This is your host, Ed Bolter, inviting you to join us again in the future for more railroading adventures from Deluce Video.